Hi girls, this is your science miss. I hope you all had gone through the unit 17 Animal Kingdom, which I sent on Monday. In this session, we are going to highlight few important points that is Animal Kingdom. All the organisms in this world are divided into 5 kingdoms that we have already studied in last year. Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. How we classified these animals? Classification is the ordering of organisms into groups on the basis of their similarities, dissimilarities and relationships. What is classification? The method of arranging organisms into groups on the basis of their similarities and differences is called classification. This is also called as taxonomy. Taxonomy is the science of classification. This taxonomy is introduced by Swedish botanist Carolus Linnaeus. If we take an order of classification, the basic simplest taxa is species, and the next one is genus and family, order, class, phylum, and at last kingdom. So species is the lowest taxonomic category. And the next one is genus. Genus is a group of closely related species. And the next one is family. A family is a group of genera with similar common characters. And order. Order is a related families having common characters. And the next one is class. Related or similar orders together form a class. Phylum. Classes which are related with one another constitute a phylum. And next to that is kingdom. Kingdom is the highest category and the largest division. So, species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, and kingdom. This is the taxonomic category. And now we are going to continue with basis of classification. How we classified the organisms by using different characters. They are levels of organization, arrangement of cells, body symmetry, germ layers, and the nature of coelom. We start with levels of organization. Already last year we studied about unicellular and multicellular organisms. So levels of organism is, that is, we divide organism into one cell organism into unicellular and many cell organism as multicellular, and then tissue grade, organ grade, these are the levels of organization. And the next type of base of classification is symmetry. What is symmetry? It is a plane of arrangement of body parts. That is, if we divide an organism into two equal half, then it is called symmetric animal. If you are not able to divide an organism into two equal parts, then it is asymmetrical. Here the symmetry is divided into two, that is radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. Radial symmetry means we can divide an animal into two equal halves at any point. In bilateral symmetry, we can divide an organism into two equal halves at only one point. That is bilateral symmetry. For bilateral symmetry, examples for bilateral symmetry are radial symmetry. Hydra, jellyfish, starfish. For bilateral symmetry, example is frog. Germ layer. Germ layer forms during the development of an embryo. Organisms with two germ layers, that is ectoderm and endoderm, are called diploblastic organisms, example Hydra. The organisms with three germ layers, that is ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm, are called triploblastic organisms, example rabbit. And the next one is coelom. Coelom means body cavity, fluid filled body cavity. A true body cavity or a coelom is that one is located within the mesoderm. So we divide this we divide organisms into three groups according to the presence of coelom, that is acoelomates, pseudocoelomates and eucoelomates. Acoelomates means do not have body cavity, example tapeworm. Pseudocoelomates means false have body cavity, example roundworm. Eucoelomate means true coelom, that is presence of true coelom, example earthworm, frog and so on. This is the diagrammatic representation of acoelomate, pseudocoelomate and eucoelomate. Now, this is the diagrammatic representation of animal kingdom. Last year, you studied about different phylums of animal kingdom. Do you remember that? Porifera, Coelenterata, Platyhelminthes, Acelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata and Chordata. Here, these phylums are classified into, further divided into this levels of organization. First level Porifera comes in cellular level and the next one Coelenterata comes under organ or organ system level, and the next remaining phylums comes under the coelomic level, true acoelomate, pseudocoelomate and true coelomic. And in your lower classes you studied about invertebrates and vertebrates. Do you remember this, girls? Animal kingdom is further divided into two groups, that is invertebrata and vertebrata, chordata, prochordata and vertebrata. Animals which do not possess notochord are invertebrates. Animals which possess notochord or backbone are called chordates. It will come in differentiation. What is notochord? A two-mark question. Notochord is a rod-like structure formed on the mid-dorsal side of the body during embryonic development. Binomial nomenclature. What is binomial nomenclature? Corollis Linnaeus introduced the method of naming the animals with two names known as binomial nomenclature. Here, this is a representation of some binomial names of familiar organisms. Do you see this? Each and every binomial name consists of two words. The first word is genus name and the second word is species name. The first name is called genus and the first letter of genus is denoted by capital letter, and the second one is species, denoted by small letter. Few names, amoeba. For amoeba, the binomial name is Amoeba protease. For tapeworm, Taenia solium. For leech, Hirudina granulosa. Cockroach, Periplanta americana. Frog, Rana hexa dactyla. Man, Homo sapiens. Phylum Porifera, pore bearers. This animal exhibits cellular grade of organization. The important points in this phylum is canal system, spicules. Example for this phylum is Cycorn. The next phylum is phylum Coelenterata, otherwise called as Cnidaria. It is an aquatic organism. This is tissue grade of organization. Its body wall consists of two layers, diploblastic, ectoderm and mesoderm. Ectoderm and endoderm is separated by inner mesoderm with a jelly, non-cellular jelly-like substance called mesoglae. This coelenterates, the special character of the coelenterate is the presence of nematocyst, that is singing cells. Polymorphism is also a special character of this phylum. Example for this phylum is Hydra and jellyfish. The next phylum is phylum Platyhelminthes. That means flatworms. Example, tapeworm. These organisms possess diploblastic three-layered ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, acoelomate, that is without body cavity. They have parasitic mode of life. For the parasitic mode of life, these organisms possess suckers and hooks. The excretory organ is a special excretory organ present in this phylum are flame cells. These organisms exhibit a special kind of reproductive process called hermaphrodites. Hermaphrodites means the organism, both male and female reproductive organs present in the same single individual. For example, liver fluke and tapeworm. The next phylum Azelminthes, roundworms. These are bilateral symmetry triploblastic animals. The body cavity is pseudocoelom, that is false cavity. Free living soil forms are as parasites. Its body is covered with thin cuticle. Sexes are separate. Some roundworms causes diseases in human beings called elephantiasis, ascariasis. Example for the phylum Azelminthes is Ascaris. The next phylum is phylum Annelida. These animals possess segmented body, so segmented worms. Example for this is earthworm and leech. This is first true coelomatic animals, organ system grade of organization. The special character present in this phylum organisms are Cetacea and Parapodia. Phylum Arthropoda, animals with jointed legs. Arthropoda is the largest phylum of the animal kingdom. These animals have bilateral symmetry, triploblastic, coelomatic animals. The special character of this animal phylum is jointed legs. Arthropoda, jointed legs. Exoskeleton is made up of chitin. The casting or regrowing of exoskeleton is called molting. This is very important. And another special character of this arthropoda is presence of hemolymph, that is the blood body cavity is filled with hemolymph. The blood does not flow in the blood vessels. That is that's why it is called as open circulatory system. Respiration takes place through body surface, gills and trachea. The excretion takes place with the help of the malpighian tubules or green glands. Example, cockroach, millipedes, centipedes and so on. The next phylum is phylum Mollusca, soft-bodied animals. These animals are bilateral symmetry, soft body without segmentation. Its body is divided into head, muscular foot and visceral mass. And the entire body is covered by a folding of a thin skin called mantle. The presence of calcareous cell is a special character and respiration takes place through the gills or lungs. Sexes are separate. Example, snail, octopus. Here, do you know, octopus is the only invertebrate that is capable of emotion, empathy, cognitive function, self-awareness, personality, and even relationship with humans. And the next phylum is phylum Echinodermata. They are marine animals, triploblastic, true coelomates. They are radially symmetrical. Larval forms show bilateral symmetry, but adult animal shows radial symmetry. The unique character is the presence of water vascular system. Locomotion takes place with the help of the tube feet. Body wall is covered by a calcareous ossicles. Example for this phylum is starfish and sea urchins. And the next is phylum Hemichordata. Phylum Hemichordata are marine organisms, soft, vermiform and segmented body. They are bilaterally symmetrical animals with non-chordate and chordate features. They do not have notochord. Their ciliary feeders and mainly remains as tubercular forms. Example, balanoglasses. And the next one is chordata. Next part of the lesson is chordata. Chordata consists of presence of notochord, dorsal nerve cord, and paired gill pouches. Phylum chordata is further divided into prochordata and vertebrata. Prochordata. Prochordata are considered as the forerunner of vertebrates. It is further divided into subphylum urochordata and subphylum cephalochordata. For subphylum urochordata, example is Ascidian. For subphylum cephalochordata, the example is Amphioxus. And now we are going to continue with vertebrata. Vertebrata, this is a group is characterized by the presence of vertebral column or backbone. Last year we studied that vertebrata is grouped into five classes, that is class fishes, class amphibia, class reptilia, class apes, and class mammalia. Here they have given six classes. One new class is added, that is class Cyclosmata. Example, hagfish. They are jawless vertebrates. Class fishes. Class fishes are poikilotherms, cold-blooded animals. Cold-blooded animals means, what is the cold-blooded animals, poikilotherms? They can change their body temperature according to their environment. Class fishes, example, fishes. Their locomotion takes place by fins. The heart consists of two chambered. Two types of fishes are there. Cotyledonous fishes, example, shark. Bony fishes, example, mullets. More to know. The smallest vertebrate is Philippine goffin. Class amphibia. Amphi means both. These are the four-legged organism, tetrapods, dual adaptation. That means they can live in both land and water. And their body is divided into head and trunk. Always their body consists of a moist mucus gland. Respiration takes place through gills, lungs, skin, or bucko. Pharynx. The heart of the frog consists of three chambered. Example for the class amphibia is frog toad. The Chinese giant salamander is the largest amphibian in the world. The next class is class reptilia. They are fully adapted to land. Their body is covered with horny endodermal scales. Respiration takes place through lungs. All reptiles consist heart consists of three chambered except crocodile. Crocodile's heart consists of four chambered. These animals lay their eggs. Example for this class are calotus, lizard, snake. The next class is apes. All birds comes under apes. Apes are homeotherms, warm-blooded animals. Warm-blooded animals, homeotherms means they cannot change their body temperature according to their environment. That's why from apes it is homeothermic, that is warm-blooded animals. These birds have boat-shaped body. Their body is covered with feathers. Four limbs are modified into wings for flying and hind limbs are adopted for walking or swimming. Respiration takes place through lungs. They have air sacs. These air sacs helps consist of lymphatic bones. This lymphatic bones helps in flying. Weightless body. They lay eggs with calcareous shells. Example for this class apes are birds, parrot, crow, eagle, and so on. The state bird of Tamil Nadu is emerald dove, and the last file class is mammalia. Mammalia are the warm-blooded animals. Their body is covered with hairs. It bears sweat and sebaceous glands, oily glands. The special character of this mammalia is females have mammary glands. The external ear or pinna is present. Heart is four-chambered. All mammals give birth to their young ones viviparous, except few. They lay eggs. Example, platypus and spine eaters. Class examples for class mammalia are rat, rabbit, and man. The giant blue whale is the biggest vertebrate animal. Here, girls, we completed this lesson. Please go through it, read, understand the concept, and please find out the answers for the evaluation. Thank you.